Hello everyone and welcome, and let's take a look at this very beautiful old padlock. Okay, the padlock is not that old, but to me it is. So recently I've provided a fellow lock collector here in Germany with some scanned and printed information, and he told me, Adrian, that was very nice of you, so I'm going to send you a surprise package and with some nice padlocks in there. And he actually did, and I was very surprised to find this very, very beautiful old padlock in there, which is one of my favorites now. I mean, you all know that I really enjoy and love padlocks with a double bitted key, and this is the most beautiful one I have now, I think. So as you can see, this padlock was produced by a company called Ymos, but the thing is, this is a padlock from the German Bundespost. You can see here the BP stands for Bundespost, and the German Postal Service. And the thing is, before the German Bundespost was Bundespost, their name was the German Reichspost in the German Reich. And I think that the padlocks from the German Reich with the double bitted key are the same than the one from the German Bundespost later. So the thing is, the Bundespost or the Reichspost, they had the plans for these padlocks, and they provided companies, like in this case the company Ymos, or companies like Bodepanzer, who were into producing locks or safes or metal things, with these plans, and they told them, hey, we need like 1,000 of those padlocks, and please produce some for us. So the German Reichspost and the German Bundespost, they used this padlock to secure their trailers of their postal trucks. So you had a trailer or a pony trailer on your truck, and then you secured this trailer. There was a hasp on it, and this padlock was hanging on that hasp at the back of that trailer, or at the back of the truck, so you could prevent the bad guys from getting into your trailer or into the back of your truck and stealing all the packages. And this padlock was probably produced in January 1986, and the H-262 is probably the number for the key. I mean, we have the same number here on the key, and as you may see on the key, let's take a closer look at the key. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cuts, and this thing, this part here down here, will turn the locking bolt. So we have 5 cuts, which are symmetrically, as you can see, and we have five levers here in the padlock. So let's, and also the padlock features a drainage hole down here, and all the levers are made out of brass. So due to the simple but effective locking mechanism and the drainage hole and the brass levers, I would say this was also a very weather-resistant padlock. Let's put the key in, turn the key around, it's key retaining of course, and open it, and you may recognize, oh wait, there is no cutout on the shackle or anything. So if we turn the shackle around, you will see a cutout here, and this is actually where the locking bolt will lock up the padlock. I think it's only locked up from one side, but I'm not sure. I will take a look at a cutaway of this padlock from another fellow collector later, and may provide you with this information then. So down here you can hopefully see the levers and the locking bolt, which I can now not turn due to the fact that the shackle is not in there. What is also very interesting, what you probably cannot, maybe you can see it a little bit down there, that the levers are serrated on the top and on the bottom. So they made quite sure that you will have some problems picking these levers here, because we got some serious false gates on those levers, top and bottom. So I hope you enjoyed this very nice and sweet padlock, which is one of my favorites now, and I hope you have a nice evening, have a nice weekend, and take care. Bye bye.